Well, his name certainly is familiar here in Western New York and has been since he signed on the air at WKBW Radio way back in 1968 as Sandy Beach. Tonight, our man Mike Randall catches up with the legendary broadcaster just after his final broadcast today to find out what's next.
How do you top off an amazing 60-year career in radio? Well, if you're Sandy Beach, you show up for work.
I am just a regular guy.
No, not here in the WBEN studios. This is file video from a couple years ago. Since COVID, he's been doing the show right here from home. It's been tricky.
There's no stimuli to get your jokes from or anything like that. It's more efficient, but it's not as good.
We caught up with Sandy minutes after he finished his last show.
Retired now, what, 35 minutes? How's it going so far?
I don't recommend this to anybody, believe me.
He's known for his trademark humor, cutting-edge comments, and that distinctive laugh. Yeah, that laugh. Sandy says he acquired it years ago when pronouncing an unusual name.
I had a contest winner named Abner Nelms. And I couldn't put my arms around that anybody would be named Abner Nelms. And so I started laughing, couldn't stop laughing.
His sense of humor is his stock in trade, but before he got into radio, his clowning around could be problematic.
I used to have to walk home from school, which was 5 miles, because I had a detention nearly every day. Every day, and they make you, there's no late bus, no late bus.
His career has taken him around the country, and he's been inducted into 3 halls of fame.
And for the past 23 years, you've been able to find Sandy Beach at the same place on the dial.
He says it's no accident that most of his career has been right here in Buffalo.
So I love Buffalo. I like to walk into a place where I can say hello to somebody and they can say hello to me. And I feel very comfortable in Buffalo.
When some guys retire, they go fishing or find a hobby. Sandy's planning to tie the knot with his longtime girlfriend, Bernadette.
I looked up things to do while being retired, and one said get married. Because they can cook for you, they can laugh with you, they can cry with you. It's good to have a studio audience with you every place you go.
His message this morning for his many fans as he ended his 6 decades on the air.
And thank you for sharing your life with me. Because if you hadn't done that, I couldn't have done it myself. Thank you. And goodbye.
Thank you, Sandy. Mike Randall, 7 Eyewitness News.
He's a character, one of the grand old boys of radio. There are a few of us left.